You know you've had them. Budgeting failures. They happen to all of us. So don't feel bad when they happen to you. Everybody has them. Hey guys, today I am collabing with the fabulous Connie Porter, and we are talking about our budgeting failures and how we are fixing them. And I got a lot of them. I fail all the time. Seriously. All the time. Every day. Several times. So if you are new to my channel, go ahead and click that big old red subscribe button down below and then click that notification bell icon and you will be alerted every time I upload and you can be sure to join in the fun with all my cool friends because here we're all friends and everybody's cool but me. I'm such a dork. And for those of you who are longtime watchers and you don't know Connie, why do you not know Connie? She's just a fantastic person and we bounce financial ideas off of each other all the time. She is not your traditional Dave YouTuber. She goes against the grain sometimes and I love that about her. What failures have we done? We've done a lot. We've had some major budgeting failures. Now, if you don't know my backstory, we started the Dave Ramsey plan in about April 2016. But we took FPU in, I want to say 2009, and it took me a really, really, really long time to get Mauricio on board with the whole Dave Ramsey plan. And if you want to see that video, I will link an eye in the sky for that. So we're not new to budgeting at all. I have been budgeting like the Excel spreadsheet budgeting since 2009, but I never reconciled. And I feel like reconciling is the difference between succeeding and failing. Like I never tracked my expenses to see how on track I was, whether we were going over budget or under budget or not. And legitimately, we have some months we go over and we have to pull money from the next month to pay this month's bill. It's a whole debacle. It happens. Mistakes, budgeting mistakes are just a part of the process, but you learn as you go. And now that we're using every dollar, it's so much easier to track. And that we made was annual expenses. There were certain things that we pay annually that we were not planning to pay. They were never in our budget because I always forgot they were coming because you only pay them once a year. And those things are like, we used to pay our car insurance annually, and life insurance annually, and Amazon Prime, Costco membership, personal property tax. Now that we're on every dollar, if you look through our budget, you'll see in every dollar, I put the annual expenses and when they show up. So we don't forget them. We have stopped paying our car insurance and our life insurance annually, and we pay them monthly. And once we are debt free, we will do double payments where we are doing a sinking fund for them and paying them. And additionally, I have programmed Cozy. I know you guys know that I use Cozy to track our financial stuff and our social calendar. And that way we can look at the month ahead and see the events like birthdays and whatnot that are going to cost money as well as our financial expenses. And that has worked fantastically, but I have in our Cozy calendar the annual payments set to reoccur annually and the monthly payments set to reoccur monthly and the biweekly payments set to recur biweekly, whatever. Having that auto-generate and being able to print out a calendar when I'm going to do the budget to make sure that it is all synced up, major help. The second major screw up we had was very, very early on, and it took us a while to recover from it, and that was being too strict with the budget. When we first started the plan, it was, go hard or go home, and we went home. Because we couldn't go that hard. And so when we started this second round, we have a lot of things in our budget that some people call frivolous. Much like dieting, too strict of a diet will cause you to binge. Too strict of a budget will also cause you to binge. So we have cut out what we can survive without, but we leave things in there. Like many people tell us that our blow money is high. Mauricio gets $20 a week and I get $20 a week. And legitimately, I understand that. Some people get $20 a month. But for Mauricio and I, that $20 allows us to go out to lunch maybe once a week. Or for Mauricio, it allows him to get, you know, 4 or 5 cups of coffee a week. Things that would cause us to fall off the wagon, really having that $20 in there really, really helps us stay focused. And sure, it might take a month or two longer to get out of debt, but it's important that we be in it for the long haul. The next major issue was a major issue this year. And this is the first time it's been a major issue because it was taxes. And if you didn't see the drama that was our taxes this year, I'll link that in the eye in the sky. It was a debacle. And what ended up happening is I just hadn't withheld enough. We never owe on taxes. We've never owed on taxes. This last year, Mauricio was working at a job that didn't withhold taxes. And so I thought I was withholding enough for taxes. We didn't save it. We pulled it out of my paycheck based on what we thought he would earn. That way it didn't work. So we upped that. If Mauricio were self-employed again in the long term, it would probably be a problem for us. We'd have to come up with a different way. We'd probably have to save a certain percentage of his salary and just pay quarterly estimated taxes rather than the way we were doing it, because the way we were doing it did not work out. I ended up just withholding more for next year. But Mauricio has a job that withholds taxes now, which is fantastic. So it shouldn't be an issue anymore. The next issue was Mauricio's spending. Mauricio legitimately is very much a go and pay for something with the card and not consult me if there is money in the account. And that has been a problem from day one. And in fact, he just did it last night. He decided he needed a cord at Micro Center for his headphones. For his new job, because it's a whole cord issue, I guess. So he just bought it and there was no real consultation, and that's the way he shops. And I'm not going to change that. I've tried to change it. I've gotten angry at him. So I've learned to adapt. And rather than having a fight about it, he knows that over a certain amount, he better talk to me first. But these little purchases that happen every once in a while, they're not very common, but they do happen. That's why we have the cushion in there. And that cushion is majorly, majorly, majorly important. Things come up. They absolutely 100% come up. And so what we have done is we put in a cushion. For right now, it's $100. Next month, it's going to be $300, because we know with Mauricio having a new job, there are going to be expenses that we have not planned for. You know, parking at a training, or somebody invites him out to lunch and it's a new job and he doesn't want to say no. So we're just putting it in there as like a fail safe. And I feel like with Mauricio's spending, that has saved us, because I'm not having to constantly yell at him for buying things, little things. You know, the cable was, what, $5, I think. I'm not constantly having to scream at him for issues. The next one is having a method for impulse purchasing. Now, I've completely stopped shopping because I realized that I just have major impulse purchase issues, and it is smarter for me. Although I did recently do that thrift haul where I didn't buy anything and I actually had money to buy. So maybe that's changing. And I'll link that in the eye in the sky also. So the real issue at this point is online shopping, because I don't go to Marshall's, don't go to TJ Maxx, don't go to the mall. But sometimes I get stressed out at work and I immediately go shopping online, because that relaxes me. That might be a problem. So now we have instituted the online purchase policy and it has worked really well. I did a whole video on it and I'll link that in the eye in the sky as well. I'm linking a lot up here right now. Y'all are going to have a lot of videos to watch if you haven't watched them. And the last thing were last minute expenses. And now I mentioned the cushion, and yes, the cushion is really helpful for last minute expenses. But also there's like last minute purchases of things that we need and stuff like that. And we frequently would go to Amazon because they're super easy to buy on Amazon. So we just started funding the Amazon envelope, I guess. We have a line item for Amazon specifically. If y'all don't know my budget, I actually don't budget by category. I budget by store. So, you know, I have a Walmart, I have a Target, I have a Sephora, you know, and that's the way I budget. And I know what I buy at various different stores. And so we've just put in a flat amount for Amazon. And every month we come pretty close to using it. And it helps us. Like, for example, Mauricio just started this new job and he is going to be taking his lunch, which is fine. Now he has the ability to use a microwave. And what we discovered last week is that he was using the things I use. I have 3-cup Pyrex square things. I've showed them on about a million videos. And that's what I put my breakfast and lunch in. And we had 6 of those. And so they'd last me about 3 days. Well, if Mauricio is taking breakfast and lunch, they only last 2 days. And if there's something in the fridge, then it doesn't last. And I was out of Pyrexes. And so I had to buy a set of 6 more. And I love them. I mean, they are worth every cent in the world of food prep. I use them constantly. And, you know, they go from the freezer to the refrigerator to the microwave. And they're very safe. And they're glass. And I just love them. So I ended up buying 6 more of those so Mauricio would stop stealing mine. So it worked out really well. I keep kicking my camera and it keeps going, I've lost my mind. Kind of weird. This one is my latest video and this one is Melina. And
you guys know me.
Melina, what did you do this weekend?
Swim.
You were in your first swim meet, weren't you?
Yes, I was in swim team. When it was first summer, I said, we want to go in swim team, and I was in swim team yesterday.
So, did you love it?
Yes.
Can you say bye to the folks?
Bye-bye.
Do you love me? Do you love me, Mocha Mocha? You realize the folks are, oh, thank you. You realize when you put your head back like this, the folks are looking right up your nose. Nobody wants to look at your boogers. So we have come up with the bang growing out issue. We are covering it with a bow. If you are new to my channel, make sure you click on my big laughing face to subscribe to my channel. And I will put up 2 videos so you can keep on watching. This one is my latest video. And this one is one YouTube picked out just for you. So I'll see you in the next one.
See ya!